Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about tensor products of graphs, a binary graph operation that is also known as the graph categorical product. The tensor product of a graph depends upon Cartesian products of sets, so if you're not sure how to find the Cartesian product of two sets, check out my video on graph Cartesian products to find out. If we have two graphs, G and H, their tensor product is itself a graph with vertex set equal to the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of the graphs G and H. That is, each vertex in the tensor product graph will correspond to a pair of vertices from graph G and H, where the left entries in the pairs are vertices from graph G, and the right entries in the pairs are vertices from graph H. Also, two vertices in the tensor product connect to each other, or are adjacent, if the right entries of their pairs are adjacent but different vertices in graph H, and the left entries of their pairs are adjacent but different vertices in graph G. This condition for adjacency is highlighted in yellow below. Think about how the conditions for adjacency in a tensor product differ from those in a Cartesian product of graphs. Let's now work through some examples of tensor products of graphs. What is the tensor product of two path graphs with two vertices each? First, we need to find the vertex set of the tensor product. That would be the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of the two path graphs, AB and 1, 2. Alright, so our tensor product will have four vertices. Now what about their adjacencies? Let's take it one vertex at a time. For vertex A1, we are looking for a vertex whose left entry is a different vertex adjacent to vertex A in graph G, and whose right entry is a vertex adjacent to vertex 1 in graph H. Looks like B2 is the only vertex that meets these conditions. Notice that A1 could not connect to any vertex with letter or left entry A, and could not connect to any vertex with number or right entry 1. What about the adjacencies for vertex A2? In this case, we're looking for a vertex whose left entry is adjacent to vertex A in graph G, and whose right entry is a vertex adjacent to vertex 2 in graph H. Only vertex B1 meets these conditions, so we can connect these vertices. Again, vertices with the same letter or the same number don't connect. Instead, we connect vertices only if their letters, or more generally left entries, are adjacent vertices in the first graph, and their numbers, or more generally right entries, are adjacent vertices in the second graph. According to these rules, we are finished, as B1 can only connect to A2, and B2 can only connect to A1, both of which we already connected. Now let's find the tensor product of a cycle graph G with five vertices and a path graph H with two vertices. First, find the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of the two graphs. Okay, so our tensor product graph will have 10 vertices. Now let's determine the adjacencies. According to our adjacency condition, A1 only connects the vertices with letter B or E, or in other words, whose left entries are vertices adjacent to A in graph G. We also know that A1 will only connect to vertices with number 2, or in other words, whose right entry is a vertex adjacent to vertex 1 in graph H. Therefore, A1 connects to B2 and E2. I encourage you to pause the video and find all the adjacencies yourself, using the condition in yellow in the bottom left-hand side of the screen. Here they go. We can actually rearrange this so the result is clearer. The tensor product of a cycle graph with 5 vertices and a path graph with 2 vertices is a cycle graph with 10 vertices. What's interesting is that similar to the Cartesian product of graphs, we essentially copied our left graph twice, once for each vertex in the right graph. Then we disconnected each copy, leaving only the vertices, as in a tensor product of graphs, vertices with a matching left or right entry that is vertices in the same copy, cannot connect. Then we connected vertices from different copies according to our adjacency rule. This fact leads to the result that tensor products of a path graph with two vertices and any other graph are bipartite. Here is our previous tensor product arranged to show its bipartite structure. In a bipartite graph, there are two independent sets of vertices, or sets of vertices that are not connected to each other, one for each copy of the left graph, as each vertex in a copy is only connected to vertices in the other copy. The result of the tensor product of any graph G with a path graph with two vertices is known as the bipartite double graph of G. Let's do just one more tensor product example together. Let's look at the tensor product of two path graphs with four vertices each. First, we need to find the vertex set of the tensor product. Feel free to pause the video and try this yourself. Next, we'll need to connect the vertices according to our adjacency rule. According to our rule, highlighted in yellow, vertices will only be connected when their right entries or numbers are adjacent vertices in graph H, and when their left entries or letters are adjacent vertices in graph G. Let's look at the adjacencies for vertex A1. Vertex A is adjacent to vertex B in graph G, and vertex 1 is adjacent to vertex 2 in graph H. Therefore, according to our adjacency rule, vertex A1 is adjacent to vertex B2 in the tensor product. I encourage you to pause the video and work out the rest of the adjacencies yourself. Here they go. Finally, the intuition behind tensor products of graphs, or really any graph product, is that each vertex in one graph copies the entire other graph's vertices, and then adjacencies between those vertices are created according to specific adjacency conditions. It is those adjacency conditions that separate tensor products from Cartesian products and from other types of graph products as well. If you're curious, there are actually 256 different graph products that can be defined where the vertex set of the product is the Cartesian product of the factor graph's vertex sets, and the adjacency conditions between two vertices represented by an ordered pair of vertices from each factor graph, UV and U' V', are some pair or combination of pairs from the following six statements. Remember that U and U' are vertices in one graph, and V and V' are vertices in the other graph. When we say that U equals U', we mean that U and U' are the same vertex. And the same goes for when we say V equals V'. Just with these six statements and the Cartesian product of vertex sets, it is possible to define 256 different graph products, as there are 8 pairs of statements. This is excluding the case where U equals U' and V equals V'. With these 8 pairs of statements, and the fact that we can choose as many or as few of them as we want, we have 2 to the 8, or 256 possibilities. That's it for this video, but I'd like to leave you with a few challenges. Is the tensor product of two bipartite graphs also bipartite? And is the tensor product of two disconnected graphs disconnected? Let me know what you think in the comments. In my next video, we're going to look at strong products of graphs. And after that, King's graphs, a chess-related graph defined using a strong product of two path graphs. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.